Hello and welcome to the Penguin Prof Channel. Today I want to talk about unit conversions without tiers. I want to show you a strategy that just always works, how to convert equalities into fractions, how to get the units you want using the power of the number one, and how to derive even weird conversions like Celsius to Fahrenheit so you don't have to memorize everything. So let's get into it. When you look up conversions, you're going to see equalities like this, and my students will ask me, but how do you use these? And what the f*** is this? And why is this one so ugly? Okay, so here's the thing. You can multiply anything by 1 without changing its value. You already know this. Any number multiplied by 1, it's the same number. Yeah, of course. But sometimes 1 doesn't look like 1. So what you have to do is transform these equalities into fractions, and then you can use them to multiply by 1 to get the units that you want. So let's look at this one. 1 hour equals 60 minutes. So you can put 1 hour over 60 minutes. That's equal to 1. You can also flip it, 60 minutes over an hour. That equals 1. 1 cup is equivalent to 8 ounces, so that's 1. You can flip it, it's still 1. So we've got mils to liters, we've got miles to kilometers. You get the idea. All of these things are equal to 1. So how to use conversion factors? I recommend you start with what you're being asked and actually put a question mark there. Then set it equal to the information you're given, and then multiply by 1 using conversion factors that will cancel out the units you don't want, leaving you with the units that you do want. As an example, the weight of this king penguin is 16 kilograms. So how many pounds is that? And you're given the conversion 1 pound equals 2.2 kilograms. Okay, let's do it. Start with a question mark. How many pounds is 16 kilograms? Now I can do 1 kilogram over 2.2 pounds, but my units are not going to cancel, so that's not going to work. I'm going to have to use it the other way. 2.2 pounds over 1 kilogram. Now my units cancel and I get my answer in pounds. Okay, let's build on that a little bit and do this next one. How many seconds are there in 2 years? Now I picked this one because we're going to multiply by a lot of number ones. How many seconds in 2 years? 365 days in a year? That's a number one. 24 hours in a day? Also one. 60 minutes in an hour? That's one. And 60 seconds in 1 minute. So now I can cancel out days, I cancel out my hours and my minutes, I do the math, and I'm left with seconds. Okay, so now hopefully you're getting the hang of this. There are two things to consider when thinking about conversions. Number one is, what is the size of the unit? You can think about the size of the increment between 1 and 2 centimeters, for example, and 1 and 2 inches. You see how the size of those two things are different? So when they're different, that conversion will require multiplication. The second question is, do the zero values coincide? And here on the length scale between centimeters and inches, they do. But between the Celsius and Kelvin temperature scales, they don't. They are offset, meaning 0 Celsius does not line up with 0 Kelvin. This means that the conversion between the two will require addition. So let's do a quick example. So this is so easy. How many Kelvins is 5 degrees Celsius? All I have to do is add the offset, and that's my answer in Kelvins. Okay, how about the trickiest one of all? Between Celsius and Fahrenheit, we have different sized units and they are offset. That means that when you convert between the two, you're going to have to multiply and add. Now, deriving the conversion between Celsius and Fahrenheit requires you to remember one thing, and you probably know this already, and that is the temperature at which water freezes and water boils. Now, the difference between those two numbers on the Celsius scale is 100, and the difference between the two on the Fahrenheit scale is 180. Now, that's the conversion factor that we need, and you'll also notice there is an offset. 0 Celsius is 32 Fahrenheit. Now keep that in mind, that 32, we're going to have to add that in when we do the conversion. Okay, here we go. How many degrees Fahrenheit is 37 degrees Celsius? I'm going to multiply by that conversion factor, 180 over 100 plus 32, the offset. Celsius cancels. Now I can actually simplify this. 180 over 100 is 9/5. And again, showing that the Celsius cancels, I do the math, I get 98.6 Fahrenheit. Okay, so in summary, most conversions involve different size units, so you're going to be multiplying. Offsets are rare. You're going to start with a question mark and what you want. You're going to set it equal to what you are given. And you're going to transform the equality into a fraction to get rid of the units that you don't want. And finally, please keep track of your units. They might save your life one day or your job. Have you read about NASA's Mars Climate Orbiter miscalculation from 1999? NASA was using newtons and Lockheed Martin was giving them pound force. Just keep track of your units. As always, I hope that was helpful. Thank you so much for visiting the Penguin Prof Channel. Please slam some buttons below if this video was helpful, and I'll see you in the next one. Good luck.